Hello everyone, myself Praful Tarvatkar. In this second lesson, we are exploring various applications of solar energy. As we know, the heat energy of sun is enormous, and the same, if properly harnessed, can be used for heating living spaces, the most common application of solar energy. Solar energy can be applied in various forms in various types. They are passive solar energy, active solar energy, photovoltaic solar power, solar thermal energy, and concentrated solar power. Let us see each type in brief. Passive solar energy. In this method, solar energy is harnessed in its direct form without using any mechanical devices, like drying clothes in daylight. Active solar energy employs mechanical or electrical equipment for functioning, which improves system efficiency. For example, solar water heater using water pumps. In solar thermal energy, the heat energy is derived from incident solar energy using solar heating panels. For example, solar thermal electricity generation. Photovoltaic solar energy means conversion of incident solar energy into electricity using solar PV cells. Concentrated solar power is one type where large amount of electrical power is generated using solar collectors. Now, take a pause for a while here and try to answer this reflection spot. What are the various applications of solar energy? You can pause this video for a while here and write your answer on a sheet of paper. So, as we were finding various applications of solar energy, here are few applications listed below. Solar water heating, solar PV generation, solar cooking, and solar energy for indoor and outdoor lighting. Solar thermal collectors are special heat exchangers which transfers solar radiation energy to some transport medium like air, water, or oil. There are basically two types of solar collectors. First, a flat plate solar collector, and second, an evacuated tube solar collector. A flat plate solar collector consists of an absorber material covered with a glass top. You can see here. Incident solar energy is collected by these absorbers by the use of convection. Then they are transferred over the medium. The evacuated solar tube collector, water flows through the tubes and the absorber collects incident heat energy which heats up the flowing fluid through these tubes, as you can see here. Hence, the incident heat is now converted into heat energy. The next application of solar energy is making use of solar cell to convert incident light or heat directly into DC electrical energy. Let us now see in brief the construction of a solar cell. A solar cell is basically a combination of P and N semiconductors placed in layers. To protect these layers, glass lens is taken over the top. This solar cell has a characteristic light, like when the solar radiation is falling on the surface of a solar cell, the P and N type semiconductors starts reacting with each other and emits electrons. Now, the charges are produced over the surface of the solar cell. One surface is positively charged, whereas the other source's surface is negatively charged. Hence, the positive and negative potential is available across the solar plate. If a load is connected across these two surfaces, the current starts flowing through it. The output of a solar cell is a DC voltage. Then we can convert this DC voltage to AC for general use with the help of an inverter. Here you can see the symbol of a PV cell also. Hope now you understand the basic applications of solar energy. Thank you.